In convenience stores all over the country, people from all walks of life line up out the door to purchase a lottery ticket. Some play just for fun, some play out of desperation, but all believe that winning would change their life for the better. In reality, winning the lottery has a tendency to bring out the worst in people. Suddenly they find themselves with fame and fortune. Many simply don't know how to handle it. They overestimate the amount of money they have and spend recklessly. Or maybe they trust the wrong people and wind up getting swindled. A few have even been murdered for their wealth. There is a reason for the saying, "Money can't buy happiness." In this ongoing series of videos, I'll be examining the stories of people who have had their lives ruined by winning the lottery. I'm Lola Tarantula, and welcome to Lotto Losers. Jack Whittaker was a lucky man. He had a loving family and a successful business that had made him a millionaire. He was generally well-liked, too. Even with all of his riches, he remained a humble cowboy from West Virginia. Now, Jack could have lived the rest of his life comfortably, but Lady Luck wasn't done with him yet. On Christmas night, 2002, she bestowed Jack with the ultimate Christmas gift, a $314.9 million Powerball win. At the time, Jack was the biggest lottery winner in US history. But it didn't take long for the wheel of fortune to turn, and soon Jack's tremendous luck became the ultimate curse. Jack was a philanthropic man with a strong desire to share his prize. He gave a whopping 10% to Christian charities and created the Jack Whittaker Foundation with the goal of feeding and housing the poor in his community. He even donated a hefty sum to the clerk at the store where he purchased the winning ticket. Jack was also generous with his family. He lavished his teenage granddaughter Brandy with cash and gifts. Most people with common sense would realize that giving a teen large amounts of money is a bad idea, but life had been hard for Brandy, and Jack felt bad for her. She had lost her father to suicide, and her mother Ginger was chronically ill. Even though she was so young, Jack believed Brandy was responsible enough to handle what he'd given her. It was a decision he would come to regret. Now, Jack's judgment regarding Brandy may have been compromised by all of the bad choices he was making for himself. Jack portrayed himself as a dutiful Christian, a pillar of the community. The reality is, he was anything but. Jack had begun drinking heavily, gambling, and frequenting strip clubs. These vices brought him nothing but trouble. One night while at a club, he left a suitcase with $545,000 inside his car. Unsurprisingly, his car was broken into and the money was stolen. Now you may be wondering why he would carry around that kind of cash. When asked about it, he simply responded, "Because I can." He didn't learn from the incident either. Later, he had an additional $200,000 stolen from his vehicle. He also nearly fell prey to two greedy club employees. The managers at the Pink Pony Club were arrested for conspiring to drug and rob him. The couple had intended to dose his drink and make off with his money. Witnesses caught the pair in the act, and the police intervened before they could succeed. Still, the incident drew negative attention to both the club and Jack. People were beginning to have doubts about the man they had previously considered a hero. Jack was so busy with his downward spiral that he failed to realize that Brandy was also losing control. She had surrounded herself with the wrong crowd and began an ill-fated love affair with crack. To keep her new friends around, she passed out cash like it was candy. Her carefree days of drug binges and shopping sprees continued for some time. Then the party died, along with Brandy's boyfriend. Brandy's boyfriend Jesse Tribble had OD'd on a lethal drug cocktail at Jack's lake house. Jesse's father and friends placed the blame squarely on her. Under the weight of grief and guilt, Brandy became increasingly paranoid and depressed. This only served to further her addiction. A few months after Jesse's death, Brandy disappeared. The incident put a great deal of strain on Jack and his family. His wife Jewel told the media that she'd wish she'd torn up their winning ticket. Things got worse when Brandy's body was found, wrapped in a tarp and hidden behind an old van in an area dubbed Scary Creek. A toxicology report indicated that she had cocaine and methadone in her system, but could not conclude a definitive cause of death. In the wake of the loss of his precious granddaughter, Jack began to lash out. During a court hearing for a DUI, he railed against authorities for going after him instead of those he held responsible for Brandy's death. Things kept going downhill when Caesars Atlantic City Casino sued him for $1.5 million in gambling losses that he owed. Later, he owed money to a woman that had sued him for sexual harassment, but was unable to pay her because thieves took the last of his fortune. The thieves had cashed different checks at 12 different City National Bank locations. 3 years went by, then Jack's daughter Ginger passed away. No official cause of death was released, but it's possible her death was related to her illness. The Jack Whittaker lottery saga ends in the same dramatic fashion as a gothic novel. In 2016, Jack's Virginia home went up in flames. The fire consumed the entire house, ruining everything. Jack had quite literally burnt his life to the ground. His wife was inside at the time, but she managed to make it to safety. Being the bright bulb that he was, Jack didn't have the property insured. All of his losses forced Jack to do some very painful introspection. He regretted winning the lottery, stating, "I don't like the hard heart I've got. I just don't like what I've become." To make amends, he began volunteering at his church and putting more emphasis on family instead of money. Jack Whittaker's story is the tragic tale of a man that traded his comfortable but mundane life for the high-rolling life of a rock star. Jack may have won big in Powerball, but he lost in the lottery of life. His careless ways cost him his reputation, his property, and eventually his family. Perhaps he can rise like the phoenix from the ashes, but his name will forever be tarnished by his mistakes. With that, we have reached the end of the Jack Whittaker saga. If you liked this video and you want to hear about more Lotto losers, please like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you can keep up with all my videos. Thank you so much for watching.